minutes on the amendment.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Members, this amendment is an amendment that we've considered for the last couple of years, and it has passed by voice vote the last couple of years, and it's something that's needed. Basically, this is what we call the H-2A workers, where we allow workers to come in and provide labor or services to the agricultural community, regardless if it's temporary or seasonal. Now, for anybody that feels that this is something that's not needed, we do know that if you represent any rural part of the country, there are farmers, ranchers that need this type of assistance. And therefore, we're asking that that we provide these workers. The other thing is, and Mr. Newhouse is going to be speaking because this is an amendment by both of us, is that for anybody that thinks it's easy work, my father was a migrant worker, and he was out there in the sun, and he was out there working. It's not an easy job to be done. But the workers are needed, and therefore, if Americans don't want to do this job, somebody's got to provide this job, and this is why this temporary program is needed. So, members, I think we've done this before, and I would ask you that it doesn't change anything just for this year, that we allow this type of H-2A visa workers so they can come in and do the work regardless if agriculture is seasonal or not seasonal. With that, I yield the balance of my time. I don't know my good friend.
Mr. Newhouse is recognized a co-sponsor of the amendment.
Thank you, Madam Chair. And I'd like to thank my colleague from Texas, Mr. Cuellar, for helping me with this amendment. Before I make any comments on that, though, I'd just like to real quickly express my appreciation to Ms. Roybal-Allard and Mr. Fleshman. You know, serving on the Homeland Security Subcommittee, it truly is an honor, and it's a huge responsibility, as you can tell from the comments and discussion today. This is one of the most important subjects that we deal with as Congress, and I just want to express my thanks to the chair lady for her wonderful way of running the committee, also for taking us on so many educational field trips. We've been to DHS, we've been to TPS, we've been to Targeting Center. We took a trip to the border, among other things, really trying to increase our understanding and knowledge. So, Mr. Fleshman, Ms. Roybal-Allard, thank you. And as Mr. Cuellar mentioned about this amendment, it really is needed. I'm one of the few farmers in Congress, and I can tell you from firsthand experience, agriculture is changing. It truly is. The H-2A program is a program for agricultural workers. It's for temporary work. Well, in today's agriculture, it's not all temporary. There's a lot of things that are permanent positions, but we still have the difficulty of filling those positions because, as Mr. Cuellar referenced, many Americans do not want to work in agriculture for a lot of different reasons. It's tough work. It's out in the elements. It's not for everybody. And so we need to have people from outside the country come in and help us get the job done, to help feed Americans, to help feed the world. It truly is an important thing. So because of the changing complexity of the agricultural industry and the lack of, a critical lack of workers in this country, if you talk to any farmer and ask him the three most important things that they worry about, labor is going to be in that list. I can guarantee you that. So to be clear, this change, if adopted, would keep H-2A. It would still be a temporary program, and it would not change the time limits that a worker employed through the H-2A program can stay in the United States. It would not change the requirements on farmers to show that they are first hiring domestic workers. It would just ensure that all of the agricultural industry can utilize the H-2A program, and I would respectfully ask for your support. Thank you, Madam Chair.